Oh, look, a papaya. But why does it look so sick and sad? I should ask Professor Arf about this. Professor Arf?
Yes, Xiaodik, how can I help you?
How can I look at this papaya?
Oh, this is the case of the ring spot virus.
No wonder you have so many spots on it. How can we cure it?
We can't actually cure it, but we can prevent it. I will show you how. Target protein genes identified in the ring spot virus are cut using restriction enzymes and isolated. DNA plasmid removed from the Argobacterium cell and cut with the same restriction enzyme. Place the isolated protein gene in the DNA plasmid to form the recombinant plasmid using DNA ligase and complementary CTN. The recombinant plasmid is placed back into the Argobacterium cell and the cells are fermented in the culture broth. The culture broth contains nutrients and is set at the optimum pH level for the Argobacterium to reproduce. Undifferentiated cells from a susceptible mature plant is removed and treated with the Argobacterium to infect the cells with the recombinant plasmid. Antibiotics are then used to treat and kill Argobacterium used to infect the susceptible undifferentiated cells. The cells are then grown in another culture broth. Cells then reproduce and grow into a healthy ring spot virus immune papaya.
How does the incorporated gene lead to the expression of the new trait?
Well, the viral capsid protein gene elicits something similar to an immune response, making them no longer susceptible to ring spot virus. There's some social and ethical concerns regarding GMOs are unforeseen risks and dangers due to the complexity of nature. Not only that, GMOs are made because it is possible and not because they are needed. And they also require additional cost. Benefits of GMO are a higher crop yield and more income for farmers.
Wow, thank you for explaining it to me, Professor. Goodbye.
Hello, Teddy. How can I help you?
Not Teddy.